Have you ever wondered how to maximize natural light in your designs, or how changing the lighting fixtures in your building would impact energy efficiency? Or perhaps you've questioned the financial impact of lighting changes, or how it impacts lighting quality? In the presentation, Optimizing Building Designs with Autodesk Revit MEP and 3DS Max Design, Autodesk technical experts Jay Ayala and Eddie Perlberg shed some light on these questions and how to extend the power of Autodesk Revit MEP, Autodesk 3DS Max Design, and Green Building Studio for lighting analysis and improved energy efficiency. You'll see in-depth screen demonstrations on gathering baseline energy consumption, performing lighting analysis with LED, fluorescent, and natural lighting, conducting lighting schedules, and calculating energy savings. Visit www.autodesk.com/optimize-lighting to view the entire screencast, or stay here and watch a demonstration from Autodesk technical specialist Eddie Perlberg on the chapter Performing Natural Lighting Analysis.
Well, there are two different ways we can approach bringing daylight into our scene here in 3DS Max Design. As you might remember, if we go to the reload option of our file link manager, we can go ahead and check on our daylight system, and that'll bring in all the data that's associated with that file that you've created in Revit MEP. But I'm going to take a little bit of a different approach this time. I'm going to go ahead and type in T for the top view, and now we're going to go over to the Create panel and to the Systems element and go ahead and put in a daylight system here in 3DS Max Design. You'll see that because we're putting in a daylight system, I'm getting a little dialog box that lets me know that it's going to adjust the exposure control, and that's going to kind of tone down the amount of light that's bouncing around inside of our scene, kind of like adjusting a camera. We'll go ahead and the first pick and draw is the compass of our project, and that's going to determine where north is for this particular scene. I let go and draw back. Oh, before that, just a little reminder that it's also going to create the sky with our sun. And you can imagine that the sky has an impact on how light enters our project as well. So I'm going to go ahead and just draw back a little bit to position the sun in the sky. Now, of course, I don't want to actually position the sun in its actual position because that would actually make zoom extents kind of crazy, but I just want to make it so it's high enough in the sky so that it's above my project. So our Romulus project is a little bit taller than that. Let's go ahead and put it up at about 350 feet. So there you can see that the actual placing of the sun was very straightforward. Now let's go ahead and control some of the aspects that are going to have an effect on how the light it comes into our project. And the first one, of course, would be how the sun is set up. And you'll see that I have three different kinds of controls. I can go ahead and manually type in the longitude and latitude of our project. That would work out just fine. Or we can put in the date, time, and location. Let's go ahead and do that method. By doing that, I can go ahead and get the location. And here I have the entire world for wherever our project may exist that I can draw from and just pick off of the map where our project is going to be located. So you said Miami, Florida, so we'll go ahead and pick that off of the map. And the last thing we'll want to do is go ahead and just adjust what is the time of day. So you can see that currently it's set to noon. Let's go ahead and give it just a couple of hours ahead of time. So here we are at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, an adjustment for daylight savings for June. And you can see that now we've positioned the sun in our sky. And the next thing we could do is then generate another light analysis to see how that's being affected. Oh, of course, we're going to want to go into the lighting analysis controls and adjust again the color controls so that they represent a sunlight system rather than the artificial lights. But the last thing you did was you adjusted the direction or you rotated the project 15 degrees in a counterclockwise manner. Now I do that here by not rotating the entire project, but you can see that I can go ahead and rotate the sun in relation to the project. So you said 15 degrees counterclockwise, that I'll achieve by typing in 345 degrees. And again, you can see that it adjusted that backwards. Now the last thing we can do is, as far as setting up our sunlight system, is using the weather data file. And the weather data file is actually derived from the Department of Energy. So I've gone out to their website earlier and I've downloaded the weather data file from the Department of Energy to represent Miami, Florida. So now you can see, again, I'll need to change the time and date. So let's, again, go for that summer solstice on June 21st. So just adjusting the date and time. So one day here, and then 6 in the morning would be a little bit early. Again, I'm going to look for 2 o'clock in the afternoon and say okay. You can see that it changed its position in the view, but it didn't change its position as far as in the sky. So again, it just added a little bit of an adjustment to how I see it from the top view, but it didn't change it all that dramatically as far as its position in the sky. So now what I would do is, again, moving inside of my conference room, we would go ahead and generate a lighting analysis for what represents 0 degrees north and 15 degrees counterclockwise north. So again, to save a little bit of time, I've pre-rendered those out. So let's bring those into our RAM player. This one represents the north view. And then again, we'll bring in on the other side 15 degrees in a counterclockwise fashion. Now, I'm not anticipating all that dramatic of a difference, but you can see that as we scrub the slider back and forth, there are just a few little variations as far as the readings on our conference table. So again, you can see that if in fact you wanted to change the orientation of our project, those 15 degrees, it wouldn't have that dramatic of an effect here in the conference room. Of course, very rarely do we make decisions for the orientation of a building based on a conference room, but we may be making it for the dramatic appearance of a lobby or something like that. So again, I just wanted to show you the effects. Now again, we did this with the daylight system here in 3ds Max design so that I could show you not only how to do it, but just to reiterate that we could do this very early in the process before there even is a conference room. So whether we're deriving our concept data from Revit MEP very early in the project or getting that data from AutoCAD or even SketchUp or something like that, again, we can do lighting analysis even though our data isn't providing us with any daylight systems early.
Thanks for watching the chapter Performing Natural Lighting Analysis. To view other chapters or watch the entire Optimizing Building Designs with Autodesk Revit MEP and 3ds Max Design screencast, visit www.autodesk.com/optimize-lighting. You'll learn how Autodesk Revit MEP, 3ds Max Design, and Green Building Studio work together to optimize your building designs and save you money.